Okay, so the objective of today's lecture is we will learn about the various models of OSI. So in yesterday's lecture, we had seen that OSI management has four models. We have organization model, information model, communication model, and the functional model. So we will study two models today. So that is the organization model and the information model. Okay, so the learning outcome of today's lecture will be you will be able to understand various organization model. Now, this is the most common question that also comes in the exam. If you see many papers, even the IA papers, you can see previous years, all those are there. So apart from network standard, organization models are there. So how agent, manager, and objects are arranged? Okay, we have only these three components in the organization. So how these three things are arranged, so that forms your organization model. So there are various types in which these three things are arranged. And then we will learn about the information model, which comprises of your SMI and your MIV. So information model has the structure of management information, how your information is structured, what is the syntax, semantics, and how it is stored, in which fashion it is stored, the information is stored, that is something in the form of a tree diagram. So we will study that tree probably in the next lecture turn. So we will just have an idea of what is the management information base. So very important lecture from the viewpoint of a theory question. Okay, so organization model, if you can draw, please draw it, because usually the students draw when we have a lecture in the class and then I explain it. So this is the first organization model. So we call it as the two-tier network management organization model. Now, remember, every time I will not say OSI model, OSI model. We are doing the chapter of OSI. So because in SNMP also there is an organization model, functional model, communication model, and information model. So right now, whatever are the models, it is with respect to your OSI network management system. So now we have two tier, means two levels are there. So here, if you see in this particular organization model, I have manager, I have objects, but the agent is not there. We have only three components in the organization, that is the agent, the manager, and the object. So here in the diagram, we have the manager. So this is one level, and we have the object. This is the second level. So that's why it is called as the two-tier network management organization model. Now, why I'm telling you to draw the diagram is when you are drawing the diagram here, you can see there is no dash here, there is dash. Okay, so some explanation is pertaining to this. So here, if this is a dash, means an agent process is there. Even though we have not listed ki yahan pe agent hai hi nahi. Agar agent hoga, toh then it becomes three tier. Manager, agent, and then the objects. And also the objects are of two types. We have a managed object and we have an unmanaged object. Then we have something. Please represent the way it is given in the diagram in your answer also. Okay, so here it is MDB. What is MDB? It is the management database. And MDB is present only with the manager. So whenever you draw the block of a manager, please remember to draw the database. Okay, because the manager maintains the database. He's supposed to maintain a database. Okay, so continuing with the same diagram of two-tier organization model. The network object. So we have managed object and unmanaged object. These are objects of the network. Now, what are those objects actually? They are nothing but the network element. So yaha hum network element ki tarah baat nahi karenge. We will call it as the objects. And they are nothing but your host, your hubs, your bridges, your routers, etc. Okay, so now I hope things will be clear when I say object. So object is the host. It is the terminal that you are sitting at. Okay, so we call it as the object. And those objects, it can be classified into managed and unmanaged objects or elements. Now, I had mentioned yesterday, what is managed and unmanaged object? Means the managed object has a management process running in them. So and they are called as an agent. And the unmanaged objects, they do not have a management process running in them. Like here, you have a managed object and an unmanaged object. If I have a management process running in them, then I can call it as an agent also. That is what is mentioned here. And that's why those objects we draw with this dashed line showing that an agent process is present over there. Means that object is not just giving me the piece of information, it is into the management process. Wo bhi ek management ka part hai. Okay, it is not just an inactive element lying in the particular network. So I hope if somebody asks you what is a managed object and unmanaged object, so very simple, they managed object have a management process running in them. We can call them as the agent also. In case of two-tier model. Why in case of two-tier model? Because we don't have a separate agent over here. Okay, so yahan pe ek object jisme management process hai, we might call it as the agent. So this is your...
Ma'am, hello.
Yes?
Ma'am, can you give examples of managed and unmanaged objects?
Example managed and see objects will be the same, but isme ek management related software present rahega. That is what we have a management process running in them. So bridge will remain as the bridge, but humne ye vendor ka bridge liya hai jisme SNMP inbuilt hai, jisme TNM management software inbuilt hai. Like we have log management tool, for example, jise hamare ek computer pe you sit in the lab and you do something 9 o'clock onwards one batch comes. Okay, so now by default jo Ubuntu system hai, we are not doing the practical right now. When we go to the lab, I'll show you, we have a log file generated. So kitne baje PC on hua, kisne apna username password diya, so by default all those records get stored. Now, why that is getting stored? Because it has a management process inbuilt. Okay, so that is an open source. But now suppose if I want to know tumne kaun sa site open kiya hai or whatever it is. So for that, I need to install or incorporate a particular software. Okay, so means why I have installed that software, not for you, but for me. As a network administrator, I want to check what all things you are doing. Okay, so means a process I have installed in my computer system. So you have a host, means you have a terminal, you have a bridge, normal functioning. It is just transferring the information, whatever the function, normal bridge jo function karta hai, ya router jo bhi function karta hai. But if I want some data from the router is not able to give that data. So then it is not a part of the management process. So those objects which have an inbuilt management process, ek software hi hoga jo usme hai, and that software gives me not only crude data, but some form of finished data. So those objects, we call it as a network, managed network elements. Or unmanaged mein nahi hai. Unmanaged is what it is doing, its daily functioning of routing, transferring of signals or whatever. If it is a hub, it is a bridge, or if it is a gateway. But then how do I manage those unmanaged objects? Jisme koi management process hai hi nahi. Okay, so then for them, we have various other methods that we will see. Because see, I cannot neglect those objects. They are a part of the network. They are a network element. So when I am doing managing of those objects, I need a software inbuilt. Agar nahi hai, so then what is the solution? That we will come to know when we are doing module number 3. I hope it is clear now.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the manager, what it is he doing? The manager is managing the managed elements. Okay, so again, the word managed elements. There is a database in the manager, but not in the agent. This is something you have to remember. And see, these are the points from the theory only. Same thing is there in my notes. So all these points are important when you are writing a descriptive answer. The database is with the manager. It is not with the agent. Okay, so the manager, what he does, we had seen yesterday, the function of the manager, he puts some queries, okay, and receives the management data from the agent. It processes those data and stores them in the database. Okay, the agent can also send a minimal set of alarm information to the manager unsolicited. Now, this word is important. See, usually kya hota hai? Yahan pe hamara agent hai. Okay, suppose. So, the manager wants some data. So, yahan se signal, if I am drawing, the manager wants some data. So, he is sending a message to the agent. Then the agent replies to the manager. So this way the message transfer, when we will draw the message flow, we will be drawing it in this way. Okay, I have less space, so I'm drawing a small arrow. Now, suppose there is, as I said earlier also, there is some unwanted or alarming situation. So then what this agent here will do is, he will send an alarm or a notification to the manager. Now, this word is important, is unsolicited. Unsolicited means the manager has not asked for the data, but I on my own is sending the data, noticing that something has happened. So such kind of messages are called as unsolicited message, like nobody has asked. Okay, nobody has put on a query. Okay, so I on my own is sending the data. So those messages are unsolicited message, and that message is generated by an agent process. Okay, so those messages are called in general alarm. For OSI, we call that alarm message as notification. Okay, so you have to remember some terms. So alarms in OSI, they are called as notification. I'm not completing the entire thing, but it is called as notification. Now comes your three-tier network management model. Now just see this one. So here you have a manager, you have an MDB. The second layer, it is a dashed. So either we have an agent or we have a manager. Means ek manager upper level ka manager hai, uske niche dusra level ka manager hai. Or we can call it as an agent. Okay, now why this MDB is present over there? Because if this second level is acting as a manager, okay, then for that particular manager, I require a database. So if it is acting as an agent, I don't require a database. But if this second level is acting as a manager, I require the database. Now in this three tier, I have the managed object. Now here I am not mentioning unmanaged object. So in two tier still we had managed and unmanaged object. When we go to this three tier model, all the objects are managed, means har ek object mein ek management process present hai. Okay, so I have the entire network where all the components has the management related software installed in them. Now it depends upon every company whether they want open source or they buy some proprietary managed tools, and they will install it in their particular system. So this is your three level. So we call it as the three tier organization model. So the intermediate layer, this one, it is acting as both agent and manager. So if it is a manager, this intermediate layer, if it is a manager, what it will do, it will collect data from the network element. So the network elements are present over there. It will collect the data. It will process them a bit and it will store the result in its database. So agar manager ki tarah kaam kar raha hai, then we require a database. Now, what if this level is acting as a agent? So it will collect the data, no need for the agent to process it, and it will send that information to the top level manager. So for example, an intermediate system is used for making statistical measurements on a network, and it passes the information as needed to the top level manager. Alternatively, an intermediate अमन अमन
करो जाने दो जाने दो
okay so if an intermediate NMS it could be a local site of a network and the information is passed on to the remote site so what is this part we are telling is ki suppose I am doing some statistical measurement so then what I will collect all that data I will process that data a little bit and then I will give it to the manager or I can say that I have a local site of network and I want to pass that information to the remote site so yahan pe jo local manager hai he will collect the data okay and he will pass it on to the higher level who might be like handling many such lower level managers so this manager is handling might be more number of agents or more number of manager so this becomes the local manager okay and this manager might be sitting remotely and this local manager is passing the information to the remote manager okay so as an agent it is just transmitting the information if it is I'm considering it as a manager they will do some sort of analysis and then he will store it in the database and if this higher manager wants that particular data he can give that data later on now comes the same thing where we have the organization model we call it as the MOM organization model now what is MOM organization model MOM stands for manager of manager like suppose we have the headquarter okay at the headquarter the main manager is sitting and we have various sites okay so these becomes the remote site in that case so this was one three tier or two tier model this is also one three tier or two tier model so this manager of manager is handling those remote sites so since he is a manager he has the database and here there is one NMS running here there is the second NMS running so then here we have the managed object then we have the agent or this acts as a manager if this acts as a manager this is MDB so it can be a two tier it can be a three tier that is present over here similarly this also it can be two tier it can be three tier so yahan pe sare options diye hue hai either it acts as a manager or it acts as an agent or it acts as a agent ka network management system okay so and if it is acting as a manager I am having a database now here all the objects again there is a managed object agar dash hai means an agent process also might be running in those particular object so this presents a global view okay so this is what usually happens in everyday life we have the main headquarter at one location and we have the remote site so then this presents a global view so the structure in that way will be I have one more manager sitting that is the manager of managers okay so very simple actually all these organization model so this configuration uses an enterprise NMS and is applicable to organizations where sites are distributed across the cities it is also applicable to a configuration where vendor management system manages the domain of their respective component so I can have one vendor present over here I have one vendor present over here but then the manager of manager will be taking the data from both the NMS which is actually having a different vendors okay so it might be altogether different so again how those conversions will take place again that we will see later on so here the MOM because dekho in logo ko koi botheration karne ki zarurat nahi hai whether I use vendor A ka product or vendor B ka product my thing is I collect the data I work as a separate NMS and whatever data this manager of manager requires I pass on to him okay now it is his duty to sort out that data and arrange it in whichever manner these people want okay so The MOM, you can say it presents an integrated view of domain. So this might be why integrated view of domain. It can be one geographical area. This can be another geographical area, or this can use one technology. This can use another technology. Remember, we had studied what is domain, perspective of network management with respect to domain. So a domain can be geographical, administrative, or vendor specific product. So clear about this? The three architecture, two tier, three tier, and management of manager. Then dual role of management process. So we have already studied the dumbbell architecture. Now, what do you mean by dual role of the management processes? Here you can see one NMS is there, here one NMS is there, and it's like a dumbbell. So here what happens is, if this NMS, it acts as an agent, then that agent sends this message to the manager. If this vendor B, it acts as an agent, then that agent sends the message to the manager NMS. So from an user viewpoint, the information traverses both the network. So from when network A, the information goes to network B. Now from network B, the information goes to network A. Now who is the agent? Who is the manager as a user? I am not bothered. I just see that the information is traveling from one end to the other end. Okay, so here the example they have given is a situation would be two network service providers. They need to exchange management information between them. I might be the user of this network. I might be the user of this network. Now my network and this network are interrelated because the data has to travel a longer path. Now, this person, this manager, dono mein agent hai, dono mein manager hai. Now this, suppose network B wants some information from network A. So at that time, ye manager ban jayega aur ye agent. So that then this network A will give some data to network B. Okay. So I hope it's simple. It should be clear. So it should be noted that the manager and agent functions in the NMS, they are processes and not system. So this sentence is important. We have an agent process running in them. We have a manager process running in them. We don't have an altogether different system. Okay, so this is your dual nature of network management. So the same network can act as an agent. The same network can act as a manager. That is what the slide is telling. Now comes, so this finishes your organization model. So if OSI organization model is asked, you will be writing about two tier, three tier, and the manager of manager, and also the dual role of management process. Now something about the information model, OSI information model. Now, what information? The management messages are exchanged between the agent and the manager. So how will be the structure of that particular information? And it's not only the structure of that information. We have seen that in the manager, there is a database. Okay, so those informations are stored in those database. So in which way the information will be stored? So that is the OSI information model. So the information model is concerned with the structure and the storage of information, the representation of the objects and information that are relevant to their management. It forms the management information model. Information on network component is passed between the agent and the management process. The information model, so what it has, it specifies the information base to describe managed object. Just a switch hai, hub hai. Okay, so those are the network elements, or you can say the network object present. Okay, so in what way will I describe a switch in form of a management message? So that comes under information model. So we will study how it is, how the objects are represented. Every object will have some attribute. Okay, so based on those attributes, how do I represent an object? A counter, if I say, then that object should have a name, it should have an ID. Okay, there has to be a tag associated with those objects. So we will study ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन डिटेल. सो एट दैट टाइम तुम लोगों को क्लियर होगा कि कैसा एक ऑब्जेक्ट होना चाहिए, हाउ डू आई रिप्रेजेंट इट, एंड इफ अ मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस इज देयर, मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस इज नॉट देयर, सो अगेन व्हाट विल बी द चेंज इन द रिप्रेजेंटेशन. ठीक है, जैसे कोई स्विच से एक डेटा आया, नाउ वेदर दैट स्विच हैज अ मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस, इट डजंट हैव अ मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस, बेस्ड ऑन दैट आई नीड टू टेक अ डिसीजन. सो देन the attributes of that object will give me an idea ki wo kis type ka object hai. Okay, so we will study the object again in detail and then the relationship between those managed objects. So that all comes under information model. The structure defining the syntax and semantics of the management information is specified by SMI. Okay, now I have that information. Ab wo information ko kaise structure karna hai. Okay, so what are the syntax that I will be using of for that particular information? So those are specified by SMI, that is the structure of management information. So we will study a little bit about SMI and how I am storing the information, in what fashion will I store, whether in the vertical form or column form or tabular form, kaise humko information store karna hai. So that is in the form of a management information base, I call it as the MIB. So whenever you are explaining the information model, please remember SMI and MIB are the two things that defines the information model. Now just read this line carefully and understand. The MIB is used by both agent and management process to store and exchange management information. We have seen in the organization model that there is a database. The database is with the manager. Agent ke paas koi database nahi tha. Okay, so that's why we called it as the MDB, management database. Now we have something called as MIB. MIB is the management information base. So here also it is some storage is there of information. So this MIB will be present in both the agent and the management process. In the previous diagram, humne generally draw kiya tha, humne MIB indicate nahi kiya tha. So MIB is a virtual database. Okay, so that might be there when actually the network is working. And MDB jo hai, that is the permanent database. Okay, this question also comes like what is MDB and what is MIB? Okay, so MDB hai, it is maintained by the manager. It is the permanent database. And MIB is the management information base. It is present in both the agent, or you can say both agent and manager can have an MIB. And that is the virtual database. Okay, so using this virtual database, I can store and exchange management information. So if I talk about database, there are two databases, MDB and MIB. So we will have a diagram where you will see what is MDB and what is MIB. A simple explanation of MDB and MIB, we will understand with the example of a library. Now just this one slide, an MIB associated with an agent is called as an agent MIB. And the MIB associated with the manager is designated as the manager MIB. The manager MIB, it consists of information on all the network components that it manages. And the MIB associated with an agent process needs to know only its local information. That is his MIB view. Did you understand by this what they are meaning by this two sentence? Because it is happening that I am only speaking and only Aman has asked one question and rest, I don't know whether you are listening or not also. Yes, did you understand this two points? It is telling something about the agent MIB and it is telling something about the manager MIB. Can anybody put this two sentence, last two sentence in one word or one sentence? Yes, anybody?
Ma'am, the manager knows all the details of all the of all the network it manages, which are under that manager, and the agent will know only about its own network, which the single network which that agent is managing.
The manager will have a global information. He will have a global view, whereas the agent will have only his local information. उसके साथ जो भी ऑब्जेक्ट्स जुड़ा हुआ है, नेटवर्क एलिमेंट्स जुड़ा हुआ है, ही विल कीप ऑल ओनली दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स इंफॉर्मेशन, व्हाइल द मैनेजर विल हैव द एंटायर इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स दैट आर देयर इन द नेटवर्क. सो एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ लाइब्रेरी इज गिवन. सो सपोज अ कंट्री हैज मेनी लाइब्रेरीज, ओके, लाइक अ network or a service provider might have many networks. Okay, so you can correlate with it. Now each library, you all have visited the library, so you know the librarian has an index of all the books. So if you want to issue, you issue it, and that index of that book is noted down. And if you are searching for some books, they will search, okay, by the keywords, and then you get the index of that book. So each library has an index of all the books that is present in the library. So I have the MIB view, so our database is there. However, this is about each library, each local library of the country. However, the central index that is present at the country's main library, and that central library actually manages all the other libraries of the country, will have the index of all the books in all the country's library. Can you imagine? हमारे लाइब्रेरी में, ओके, सपोज डीबीआईटी का लाइब्रेरी में वी हैव इंडेक्स ऑफ ऑल द बुक्स. सिमिलरली देयर विल बी सो मेनी लाइब्रेरीज ऑफ सो मेनी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. नाउ मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी डिसाइड्स दैट ओके देयर इज वन लाइब्रेरी एट द कलीना कैंपस, इट्स वी कॉल इट एज द सेंट्रल लाइब्रेरी, एंड वी विल बी हैविंग इंडेक्स ऑफ ऑल द बुक्स अवेलेबल अक्रॉस ऑल द इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस ऑफ मुंबई. सो दैट बिकम्स द ग्लोबल मैनेजर्स MIB. Okay, so same way, the MIB of the agent is the local view, and the MIB of the manager will be the global view. It will have more number of indexing. So now if I want to show both MIB and MDB, so here you can see the manager has an MDB as well as the MIB. These are the managed process, okay, and the agent is already shown over here. Okay, so separate three tier nahi dikhaya hai. So the agent process is there. So the MDB, so what is the difference between MIB and MDB? So here you can see the MDB is the real database, and it contains the measured or administratively configured value of the elements of the network. On the other hand, the MIB is a virtual database and contains the information necessary for processes to exchange information among themselves. Okay, so this can be a part of the MCQ or objective question. So you should be knowing what is the difference between an MIB and MDB. I hope this point is clear, all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So the manager, this slide is telling the same data diagram. It is including both the MDB and the MIB. Okay, now what we are telling, ha, theek hai, information store ho raha hai, kuch syntax hai, semantics hai. So what kind of information actually I am storing in the MIB? So these are some of the examples of information that can be stored in the MIB. So what are those information? So managed object. So managed object, it can be a software. It can be some administrative information, or this word we have seen. Objects are nothing but the network elements. Now, when I say network elements, it can be some hardware. It can be some systems also, like hubs, bridges, routers, transmission facilities. All those are part of network elements. So if I say managed object, एक तो हार्डवेयर कॉम्पोनेंट्स आ जाएगा या सिस्टम आ जाएगा. सो वी हैव ऑल दिस थिंग्स, और इट कैन बी सॉफ्टवेयर, नॉन फिजिकल. लाइक you cannot see like bridges, routers, what those are, some physical, some terminal, some components which are present in the network, but it can be a software also. Now software does not have any physical entity, so those can be some programs which I'm managing, some algorithms also which I'm managing, or it can be some administrative information, like it can be the contact person, the name of the group of objects, or which IP group they belong to. So some information is present. So the managed object can be those kind of information also. So I hope this is clear now, what is managed object. So hamesha object ek hardware entity hoga, aisa zaruri nahi hai. Managed object can be software also, or it can be some part of information also. So these are the information that is stored in the MIB, the information of the objects that we store in the MIB. Now, how do I store the information? Kaise fashion mein hoga? So we store it in the form of a tree diagram or a tree kind of structure. So that tree, we call it as the management information tree or MIT. Okay, so the managed objects are uniquely defined by a tree structure. And remember, I simply cannot draw any tree structure. It is specified by the OSI model, and the same tree structure, it is used by the internet model also. So SNMP also will have the tree kind of structure. So tree, you know, there is a center head, like we have the college, then we have the department, under department we have various like RG groups, research groups are there. So this way the tree structure will be there. There will be the numbering, there will be an ID, a name of all the nodes that are present in the structure. So this is just a random diagram I have put to explain ki the managed objects ko agar mujhe arrange karna hai, that information I want to store, it will be stored in the form of a tree, and that tree is called as the management information tree, and I cannot change any aspect of the management information tree. It is specified by the OSI model or ISO organization. So this is the generic representation of the management information tree. So you might have studied it in lower semester also, I don't know. So we have a root in a tree diagram, we have a root, then we have under that root, we will have level one, then that level one might have another sub branch. Okay, so this branching and all, it continues in the tree diagram. So there is a root node as and well-defined nodes underneath each root nodes at different level, and we designate it as level one, level two, and level three. Now, what are these nodes present? So every or each managed object that is present, or I am trying to store the information, it occupies a node in the tree. So if I have a hub, if I have a switch, if I have a router, okay, under what category? So everyone will occupy a node. Now in what fashion, that we will be seeing. Okay, so let us see the OSI management information tree. I want all of you to draw this diagram. So I will pause for 2 minutes and I want you to draw. I'm recording. Okay, so this is the OSI management information tree, and this tree diagram is just the beginning. It will grow. So here you can see the root node, it does not have any name. Okay, so it does not have any explicit designation. So this is specified. Abhi kyun nahi hai, kaise nahi hai, hona chahiye, no logic. It is given by the OSI MIT and it is internationally adopted. So we cannot now try to find out why it is left empty. So it is left empty. No name is given to the root node. Okay, then that root node has level one mein 3 layers hai. So that is your ITU standard, ISO standard, and ISO ITU standard. Initially, what happened was we had the ITU standard. Okay, so ek branch ban gaya tha. Then it was ISO standard which came. Okay, so the second node came. Then your telecommunication and ISO, they combined. Okay, so those were some histories which were there. So then jointly they had ISO ITU. Okay, so ISO and telecommunication, remember, I had said that TNM uses ISO standard. It is based on ISO standard. So ISO jo telecommunication mein use ho raha hai, so that became a separate domain. So that's why this three root nodes got developed after the main node, which is blind. Then we have the organization. Now, iske under mein bhi bahut sara hoga, but I don't want to reach or find out all those things. Then we have DOD, that is Department of Defense. And then comes our internet. We all are interested in the internet management because the third module is on internet management. So if I want to say internet, okay, I want to highlight ki internet mein something is there. So wo internet bolne ke liye, how do I represent? So it will be, agar internet bolna hai mujhe, so what will be the ID? Ye ek object hai, internet is an object. So the ID for that internet will be 1.3.6.1. So it is important for us to know this numbering. Okay, so just read this particular slide. How do I read the information from the information tree? The ISO defines the International Standard Organization, and earlier it was CCITT. Or ITU, it defines the International Telecommunication Union. So the old name was CCITT. So in some of the book you will find CCITT, but that was the old name. The new name is ITU. The two standard organizations are on the first layer defining the managed object under them. Okay, so iske under mein objects hai, iske under mein object hai. Now since we are studying the chapter of ISO OSI, we are concerned about this particular branch. So the joint ISO-ITU node is for the management of objects which are jointly defined by these two organizations. The number in each circle, and if it is a circle, you will draw a circle. Don't make a square or a rectangle or an oval. Circle hi draw karna hai. The number in each circle, it identifies the designation of object in each layer. Thus, if I say ISO, so ISO is designated as 1. So ORG will be designated as 1.3, your DOD, that is Department of Defense. Agar I want to say Department of Defense, the ID will be 1.3.6. And if I want internet, then it is 1.3.6.1. In this way, the tree grows, the numbering grows. Okay. There will be many things under each head again, but we are directly reaching to internet. All internet managed object will be that number followed by more dots and numbers. Now you know internet. Internet is handling so many things. So if I want internet is handling this network, that component, wo component. So, and we want to represent that. So it will be 1.3.6.1. Fir aage, 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 aage. So internet will have again 11, 12 branches. So internet ke andar mein koi TCP use kar raha hai, koi UDP use kar raha hai. Okay, so many things, just some example I am giving you. So what is TCP in internet? What identity will I say? UDP under internet, what identity I will give? So all those tree diagram will go on increasing. So if OSI MIT tree is asked, you will draw till this part only. Even if it is MCQ based question, I had put that question, but since they wanted to avoid image, they did not put up in the main paper. Maine alag alag tree diagram rakha tha question paper mein. And I wanted the students to find out which is the OSI MIT tree. But wo main paper mein, they wanted to avoid image because it's difficult in putting those images. So they do not take that question. Otherwise, in theory, 2 marks, 5 marks ke liye also, we can put, I had put it in the MCQ as well. So it's a hint that I can put it if in the IA paper, if your IA paper is online. Okay, so with this, I am